South Street, Goshen Avenue heading north. Once all the zoning is complete, then I would entertain the idea of looking at that zone, and obviously at that point, if the zone has changed, whatever it turns out to be, it turns out to be. But taking three parcels of property, to me, is no different than what happened maybe 20, 30 years ago, and nothing against the businesses, but you've got lots of businesses that are in residential zones. So, you know, I think it's a bad idea. Once the full zoning has been adopted and the comprehensive plan is done, I think that's fair. But if this is in relations to, I'm thinking back, right, if this is BG for business and commercial, then the gentleman that was here last week, who wants to put a store in there, would be, I think, just not right on behalf of what we're supposed to be doing and representing. Because if that happens and I lived across the street, I wouldn't be a happy man. So I think we're doing something for somebody, if I have to say it that way. I just think the timing of this is not right. I think the zones need to be modified and adopted as such, and then everybody will be able to live with it. I think it's just going to cause issues down the road.
Any other comments?
So we're just voting for the hearing.
Just voting for the hearing?
Yep.
So motion was made by Trustee Gore, seconded by Trustee Wingo, to hold a public hearing December 19th, 2017 at 7 p.m. to hear a changing of zones.
Oh. Just a quick question.
Sure.
Do the residents get mailers just like this with the planning board?
They do. The school too.
Yeah. Yep.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Those opposed?
Nay.
Letter E, resolution, booster pumps for Tower Hill Drive residents. Let me tell you how this came about. Correct me if I'm wrong, Artie or Chris. Tower Hill used to house a water tower many years ago, and they decided to move the water tower, place it on Tower Hill.
Pride's Crossing.
I'm sorry, Pride's Crossing. And from what I'm understanding, it's the lower elevation of what the tower was on Tower Hill.
Pride's Crossing is at the same elevation that Tower Hill
was. Drive house.
Oh, okay.
It was moved for that reason.
So the reason why it was being moved is that they were going to raise the elevation of the base of the tank.
So I guess that didn't happen.
So I don't know what the reason is, but the base never got higher. There should have been increased the pressure on Tower Hill. So it's basically at the same elevation as where Tower Hill was at.
So in order for them to have water pressure, pumps have to be put into their
existing
home.
They were
existing. The two residents that I spoke to, pumps are not working anymore. And it's taking, one woman says it takes her an hour to wash her hair. So as far as I'm concerned, it's the village's responsibility to provide water to the residents. Having the booster pumps there to begin with, it's quite puzzling. So something was not done correctly, or there wouldn't be booster pumps there. That simple.
Dave, just to give you a little bit of history here, the village originally was going to put a booster station up.
Yes.
The cost of the booster station was unbelievable. So the village board decided that they were going to go with the individual booster pumps inside the house. I don't remember if it was 8 or 10 of them. It was back in 03. We found prints where the village paid the Greenhauser to design a booster station. They put it out to bid. The bids came in too high, so then they went to the alternate of putting the individual booster pumps in the houses. I went looking down at DPW where I remember where stuff was, and I couldn't find anything on how it was done or anything else like that. And I know Christine's been looking upstairs to see if we could find the original documents and the original design of it.
Design of what? The booster pump station?
Yeah. The booster pumps, individuals' homes in the houses.
Like the agreements.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was back in Mayor Curcio's day. Kevin Kropchek was superintendent.
What? So what's in the house now?
There's a booster pump in there now.
Right, so what's the issue? We can't find another pump?
No, we can. We just need to, I think, what Artie should say is, what was the original agreement? Was it, we're going to maintain it forever? You know, or is it up to the homeowner to replace it if it fails?
We never found
it. We can't find any paperwork.
No copies or no homeowners have one?
Well, we may speak to the homeowners to see if they did or not.
Well, listen, if is there anything on that pump? I mean, I recall when the us replacing, just like Reiner, right, the same thing. So if we did it, which I'm 99% sure we ended up doing it, you know, to save these people face and give them water, I think we get that done now. And if we need to find whatever paperwork later on, but I mean, you know, the precedent's been set. It was done for a reason, because they're up a hill, they can't get the water, and
I think that's what
Joe's
trying to do.
I would vote just to, get it done.
That's what Joe's trying to do.
Right. Get it.
Yeah, there's no resolution in your packet on that because we don't have one. No, nothing was given to us. Artie was waiting for some paperwork today from someone, and it never came. Right? Did you get it? No?
No.
That's why you have nothing in your packet.
The preliminary was like $800 per pump.
$850. The gentleman told me he looked up Gunfoss pumps that was originally installed, and we went online and looked for the company here out of Long Island, and we called the salesman, and the salesman was supposed to email the village hall with the specs and everything else, because the pumps that was originally installed back in 03 is very hard to get, so they suggested that we go with the next size, bigger pump. And he's supposed to send email to the village hall, you know, the specs and everything else on it. So it didn't come in yet, so we'll have to call him tomorrow. And the only reason why I got involved in it is that Joe had me up there, being the past history of the pumps.
Right now, there's
two houses, right?
Two houses that are
reported that they're built. We don't know.
Maybe that's all there is.
Huh?
But there's only 8 houses up there.
I believe it was 8 or 10 houses. Honestly, I don't know. I don't remember. We did find the plans for the booster station itself that was going to go where the tower was.
Right. Right.
Now, I don't know. Tommy, were you on the board with Lenny?
No.
You weren't?
No, Lenny, no.
My conversation with John Petrosini, said that you would be replacing these pumps about 8 times before you reach the cost of the station.
Well, I mean, for example, this thing's been in there for 20 years or more, right?
But I don't know how old this price costing water.
Was it 2003, is that right?
2003.
2001, 2000, I'm not sure when the tower was actually.
I would, I mean, personally, it just.
99.
For those people, I mean, I would treat this like a broken water main to the house and just get it done so they can live.
Yes.
So I'll make the motion to, you know, let's just get it done.
Second.
All those in favor?
Well, we're,
resolutions.
Yeah, I know, but we're looking at a monetary thing, how much, I mean, if these things are good.
Well, you got a price of 800.
850.
You know, do we want to put a number on it?
No. Well, it could be crazy.
I think, well, it's our responsibility, I feel, to give them.
You're on top, man.
To give them one.
It's all matter.
I just wanted to see the original agreement, see what they were. You know, but.
People can't watch their hair.
I understand, I understand.
You know, I mean, if a grinder pump went tonight and sewage was backing into this guy's house, we'd be out there replacing it.
We'd do a grinder.
And, you know, I mean, if a meter stalled and we couldn't get water in the house, we'd go out and do what we had to do.
You pass an open-ended resolution on.
But it's really.
Well, in an emergency, you can, do what you need to do.
Just to move forward.
And for 800 bucks or 850.
Of course we're going to do it, we're going to replace the pump, the type of pump that we needed.
Where's the pump, right by the.
It's like a sump pump.
By the main.
No, it isn't a sump pump.
No, it's like a sump.
It's like a shallow well pump.
Yeah, right.
But it's in a little bit different design than a shallow well pump. It actually boosts the pressure in the house.
Right.
So they have more.
They have to meter, right, inside of the meter, right? Well, here's a dumb question, if we treat it, as you said, as a grinder pump or anything like that, why do we even need a resolution, let's just fix it? Why do we need a resolution?
Just want to bring it to.
You really don't, and it's here now, but it should be treated like an emergency. Everybody should know about it, but, you know, at the end of the day, it's.
So when you say, where is that $16 million?
No, I'm saying, you have to do a resolution.
It's a grinder pump.
So, okay, we have a motion made by trustee Pinko, seconded by trustee Kalua, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those are opposed? So we have to work, get information on these pumps. Hopefully by, as soon as, well, as soon as the last.
We got to order it.
We have to order it.
I don't know if it's a simple one.
Do you need enough to water the pump to put in?
I don't really know how they hired the individual plumbers to install this stuff. You know, I assume they could do it. But, you know, you might need a plumber, so, you know, you want to keep that in mind, you know.
Did you survey the other residents? If you get two and everybody else got low water pressure, you're going to be getting eight more.
Well, there's 8 to 10 homes.
But that's what I'm saying, did you survey all 8 or 10?
I had, in fairness to the people up there, I asked the first person to talk to their neighbors, so we can just get this thing done.
Okay, so you have.
Only one other resident had called.
I think you also have residents on Clinton with booster pumps there.
They do, yeah.
It would be our responsibility also.
I don't, what resident?
No, they have just a booster pump.
There's a couple of them on there.
Oh, really?
Really?
They built two of them, too, it's a couple.
He said, Pete, there are a few families on.
Probably have a lot of.
They have pumps, too?
Yep. I don't know which ones they are.
In addition to that pump station, is it?
Yeah, but the closer you are to a water tower, the less pressure you have.
Goes by, probably too fast.
It went, you know, like, as they were setting the elevation, bottom elevation of the water tower, they didn't look around?
Of the tower?
To notice that it was a little bit lower than the floor of the house next to it?
What are you talking, what are you saying, John?
Well, water goes.
Right, but it's when.
The head pressure was the floor.
Right, and it's the base of the tower, it's not the height of the tower, it's what the tower.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
It's not the height of the tower.
It needs to be as close.
It's the base of the tower. That creates your PSI.
Right.
Not your height.
But the tank tower
the tank base.
Has to be almost or as close to equal as your other tank, so you have equal pressure on both sides of your system.
It is.
If one is higher and you end up with this scenario.
That's what you got right.
You don't want that.
No, we have it, he said. We do have it.
No, I don't think so.
Because if you had what Tom is saying, you wouldn't have the booster station up at Clinton Drive.
Not an engineer, can't help you.
I said the bottom of it.
The base of the tank.
That's what I said.
Right.
You just had to step back 3 feet and look to the left. Oh, wow, you need to raise it. All right. Anyway, that's done. Resolution 5F, resolution of signage, Orange County lock and door business. In front of you is proposed business, a locksmith, opening up in, I believe this was the store of where the upholstery came from. The upholstery.